And my name is Liana. Thank you, Shilpa, for the introduction. And thank you, everyone, for being here. You are amazing. And I have a clap for all of you who have made yourselves present here. All right, so first and foremost, I would like to declare that I don't normally swear. I think you can guess by what I'm wearing, because I'm a Muslim, so we don't normally curse or swear. At most, we say our prayers, I think. But if you caught me once or twice if I were to say the F word, so it will be a bonus for you, all right? Okay, so hello. My name is Liana, and change slide. I'm known as the productivity mentor and the founder of Virtual Assistance Singapore. So what we normally do is we help other business owners, busy business owners and entrepreneurs and professionals to actually get their lives straightened out and gain more time. But before all of that, in 2009, I was homeless. So my story to be in entrepreneurship and this line itself doesn't start out rosy, of course. It doesn't start out as a decision or as a choice for me to make. It started out as out of desperation, actually. So I come to terms with it already now. It was quite some years ago, but I am graced with blessings from God, because one of the night after four months of staying by the beach, I got to meet a very wonderful man. His name is Ravi Philemon. He and his partner back then, they were actually the editors of Online Citizen, that was Andrew Lowe. And I didn't know who the hell they were back then. I just knew that they were pushing a trolley with some tin biscuits around, and they were distributing on the by the beach. And I thought, perhaps it's because it's near to the New Year, right? So it's like a festive occasion. So perhaps because of that, they are sharing out the biscuits. But they know and they are aware that there are homeless people. Me, on the other hand, I do not know there are homeless families in Singapore until I myself became homeless. And I got to know that they exist. So I learned a lot during my 4 months of staying by the beach and transiting into a shelter. And one takeaway that I can get from that is being resourceful and being resilient, because when you are homeless, how in the world do you find a way for you to cook and eat over there by the beach? Yeah, you wouldn't have money to actually buy fast food or pack food every day, right? So that is my first learning and my first fucked up in life today. So fast forwarding after the homeless period and moving into a shelter, staying there for 1 year from 2009, I stumbled onto entrepreneurship in a way that I was desperate to actually earn some extra cash to actually feed my growing children. What I did not tell you earlier on was that I have two growing boys, and when I was pregnant, when I was homeless, I was actually pregnant with my third child. So when I moved into the shelter and I already gave birth, I couldn't find a full-time job, right? So one of the ways I got to actually find ways to earn money, and the only way that I could take off is actually to create things and sell. That's all, because my background was I was from the retail sector and I used to sell jewelries. So that's the only thing that I know, and that's the only skill set that I have that I could use, and thank God it's useful at that moment. So during that time, that was when I learned more about entrepreneurship, because as I was looking for venues and space to sell my handcrafted items at flea markets and bazaars, that is where I actually met other entrepreneurs, other people who are in business and who have taught me a lot. And after which, I became more ambitious. And actually, this is a video, but they actually created into a PDF, so I don't think so you can play. It's okay. Is that? Oh, okay. So I just treat you to a quick video. Okay, while they set it up. Actually, this video shows one of the startup when I actually get together with the other entrepreneurs and the other business owners that I met at the flea markets and the bazaar. So after working together, selling our goods and learning through our experiences of how hard it is to market our products and to bring it out to the public and for them to buy, right? So we get together to actually create this platform.
Hi, I'm Lena from Burnerbook. Have you ever wondered if there is a one-stop site where you could earn credible online businesses? Or if you are a business owner yourself, do you find it difficult to find a platform in Singapore to promote your newfound talent, product and services online? Here is the take on Burnerbook. Burnerbook is a review site aims to promote our local businesses and talent via our informative and interactive online media review. Apart from helping businesses gain wide exposure and brand awareness, our focus also includes helping the less fortunate low-income families and ex-offenders in Singapore to regain their footing in society. To find out more, do check out our website and subscribe to Burnerbook's channel. Till next time, this is Lena. Check it out.
Alright, if you, in case you do not know, that was me years ago. So we came together to actually create a Burnerbook to make it like a platform to advertise other business and provide online video reviews. And it went well. It actually captured media attention and all that. And I got ambitious because I want to create a social impact in a way where it helped another person apart from myself by using that. But again, after all that, what I learned when I was about to actually launch the website, my co-founders actually came to me and said that, Liana, sorry, we couldn't do it because our parents nagged at us to find a full-time job. So that was that was just it, because they mentioned to me that they have got bills to pay, and we just started out this project for like 3 months. We do raise some funds. We raised at about $50,000 for a start to actually get us to launch the website, but they gave up the idea before it got launched. So we set a full stop to that. And from there was when one of the online editors actually introduced me to another tech startup entrepreneur, and this is Brian. So from Brian is where I learned more about tech startups, technology startup. I learned more about setting up a website from scratch, coding, managing it, and all that. And part of all that skill set knowledge I learned from, no, I learned after actually I put my 3 kids to bed, and then at night I would go on to Coursera and learn how to code. I self-taught myself how to code, how to make a website and all that. So from that kind of skill set, that is where I actually partnered out with Brian, and we co-founded a platform, which is actually, can I have a show of hand, how many of you here know about TaskRabbit? Ah, there's quite a few of you. AirTasker? Oh no, AirTasker was from the UL, huh? Okay, that's all one of those. Okay, so it's actually a clone. This task I set out to do is actually a clone of TaskRabbit and AirTasker. So we bring the concept of having a marketplace where on one side someone would to actually post tasks, and on the other side there will be runners to do the tasks for you. So that's the general idea of it. So again, it captured the attention of the media. So when startup gets into the media, it doesn't mean that they are really doing great or well or good, you know. So it's just the hype of the. At this point, when we went to MediaCorp for one of this radio interview, we already interviewed like 100 of our local people who will be the runners for this particular website. So we basically have it going in a way, and our web developer was based in the US. So he's helping us to actually develop the website. So I let Brian handle most of the website development side, and I became the community manager. And this is what Task Island stands for. Next slide. Okay, so this is how our website looks like. And it not only garner the attention of the media, it's also garner the attention of VCs and those people who would like to actually fund us. We actually got a meeting for one of these organizations, a very huge prominent organization here in Singapore, who would like to fund this particular startup that we have. But at the morning of that meeting, we already have the mock-up of the website, right? At the morning of the meeting, when we are supposed to go in to present our idea, because we are halfway there, we are 1 foot inside the door really to get it funded. At the morning of the meeting, we tried to reach out to our web developer who is based in the US, and he just totally vanished on us. So we got billed. So he billed on us, and again, another fucked up in my life where we did something and it didn't get to launch. So after this, I actually sat back and reflect and asked myself, honestly, what did I do wrong? What did I not do as well to actually get something from an idea, from a concept to fruition, and something that I can really, really solve a problem in the community or, And this particular picture was when we accept the defeat. Although you can see there's smiles on faces, right? But we actually accept the defeat that we didn't get funded and we have to actually close Sus Island. So how and why I started what I'm doing now is because firstly, I need to put food on the table for my children. So when I was reflecting, I asked myself, what is the one thing that people really, really need? And I come close to serving the business and the entrepreneurs, because when I was working for when I was actually doing up Sus Island and all that as a community manager, I find that in every businesses, in every entrepreneurial journey, you will still need administrative, you still need the day-to-day operation done, right? The administrative, the accountings, the creative back ends, and whatever that you start out to do, you will still need it to be managed on a day-to-day basis. So I got the idea from there, because when we set out to do Sus Island, we usually outsource a lot of our tasks to other virtual assistants that is out of Singapore, because primarily virtual assistants exist. It's not new, it's something that exists for so many years already, but there are almost zero to none virtual assistants that exist here in Singapore itself, the people who does that. So that is how the idea come about. And I've been doing, next slide, when I launched Virtual Assistant Singapore, it finally got launched, thank God, after creating the website. And when I launched it, a few months after, we got to be in one of these very major events, which is the Key Person of Influence events, and these started the ball rolling, because this is one of the event where a lot of other business owners, my target market, are there actually. So we kickstart the business where it's supposed to be, where it's meant to be, and the time is just right. So I've been doing, next slide, Virtual Assistant Singapore since 2013 to now. This is a bonus for you, because it may look very nice when we can run the startup, we can actually really launch it and use it. But back end, you'll still at times see me doing this, and this particular image is actually something that my son captured when I was really, really engrossed doing the work, and he was actually asking me, are you a hacker, mama? I'm usually get engrossed in coding that I will, you know, like not track time anyway. So yeah, so there it is. That's part of my story from 2017 to now.